Hello all and welcome back to my channel. Hope you have subscribed my channel. If not, please do so. In this video, I will perform an endurance test in order to find a memory leak kind of issues by analyzing the heap memory being used by the application. Mostly when we perform endurance test, we go with a 70 to 80% of the user load that our application can bear. I will design a short test where I will try to generate a heavy load so that I can find some of issue related to heap. I'll add a thread group within a test plan. Cool. I will add a dummy sampler. Yes. I will increase the number of samplers. So let me do so. I will use some of a listener. Now, what I will do, I will create more number of threads. So I'll create around 1000 threads. Ramp up time I can give up for just 100 seconds. Loop it for infinite and specify the thread time, and I'll execute this test for 5 minutes. So I'll execute this test for 300 seconds. Hopefully we can find something or the other related to heap. So before starting the test, in order to monitor the heap memory, I'll be using a visual VM which comes pre-packaged with a JDK 1.8 bin folder. Visual VM. Where I can find? Yes, here. So this is how a visual VMs look like. So here I'll be monitoring the J meter. Yeah, you can see Apache jmeter.jar. It's opening this folder file. So here you can see we have multiple tabs: overview, monitor, threads, samplers and profilers. So currently we will be using a monitor to analyze the heap usage for the particular application, which is Apache JMeter. So ideally in the VM, heap usage should remain constant. We would expect a Java heap usage to remain constant apart from a small hike, which are temporary object created and finally garbage collected, but in long run it should remain constant. And if we see any upward trend, which means that there is something wrong, and then we can analyze the heap dump at particular instance. So let me quickly start my test. Go back to JMeter. Yes, and let me start my test. Do you want? No, I do not want to save my test. And my test started. So now we can look into the heap usage. Here you can see the garbage collector came. So one can monitor that as I started my test, the heap is increasing, but it doesn't mean that there is something wrong. It is because I have created a number of users, and you can see after a certain interval, garbage collector is being called every time, which means everything is working fine. The increase, it is just because I have increased the number of threads. And now my system is using around 750 MB of heap. And after some interval of time, garbage collector is being called. Yes. Now, if I'll be able to see any hiccups where garbage collector is not being called, which means there is something wrong with the garbage collector. And at that point, I need to analyze the heap dump. I'll also show you how I can analyze the heap dump. Here you can see my test is going to end soon, so I'll try to have a heap dump so that I can analyze that heap dump with the help of Eclipse memory analyzer tool. So once it will reach its peak, I'll try to have a dump of. Now I've clicked on create a heap dump, and now I'll get a heap dump. I'll download that. Meanwhile, you can see the our heap dump. Yes, again. So one can easily analyze that our garbage collector is being called after in some interval of time, and we are unable to find any hiccups in the heap memory. So where is the heap dump? Here is my heap dump. Okay. Save as. Where to save? Save in the desktop with the same name. Not an issue. I'm saving it. Let's go back to our. Yes. Now you can see that the my test has been completed, and you can observe again the heap usage has reduced as it was in the initial stage. And if I go back to my test, you can also observe here that yes, my test has been ended. So now let's go back to a heap dump and let's see how we can analyze our heap dump. I have my MAT memory analyzer tool, which is from Eclipse. Let me start this. So this is how Eclipse memory analyzer opens up. So in order to analyze any of a heap dump, we will click on open a heap dump. So we have this heap which I have generated. You can see the time frame. So it has been generated right now, and now I can open this. So once I open a heap dump, I'll get this pop-up. So which kind of reports I want? So leak suspect report or a component report or reopen a previous report. So I'll go with a leak suspect report for this time. Now we have an overview of a heap dump. We have a pie chart of objects by their size. We also have multiple actions, so we can have a complete look of a histogram, list of instances per class, dominated trees, so biggest objects, even the top consumers. We also have reports, so leak suspect and top components. And finally, we have a step-by-step component report. Let me show you the leak suspect. So with the help of a leak suspect, we can find what went wrong while we were executing our test. So problem suspect number one and problem suspect number two. So this is how this MAT memory analyzer tools by an Eclipse help us to analyze our heap dump. So let's go back to our test. So yes, finally in this test, which was a too small, but I was able to get something or the other which was related to our memory leak issue. Thank you for watching the video. Please like and subscribe my channel if video was informative, and also hit the bell icon for more updates. Feel free to drop suggestions in the comment box.